Heavenly Father, King of Kings, the creator of heaven, earth, and the sea, the one who has given us the gift of life through Messiah being sacrificed for us, that we would be able to, our sins would be forgiven us. I praise and thank you, my King, my Elohim, the wonderment of my soul, the Elohim of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the one who spoke to the Methuselah and Enoch, the one who Adam and Eve heard. And I just want to thank you at this time. I want to thank you for how you set up families. I want to thank you for showing us what happens when families stick together and work in you and yield ourselves. So I come, Father, to pray over the mind of our children, our children's children, over all the minds of your children, Father, regardless as to their age. Hallelujah. We want to thank you. Hallelujah. We want to praise and thank you, Father, for protecting and guiding their minds, Father. And I thank you for giving our children sound minds and teachable hearts. Hallelujah. You've given them minds that's capable of weighing and understanding truth. I want to thank you that our children have mind of discernment, that they discern situations that they find themselves in or choices that they must make. I want to thank you for no matter how old a mother and a father is, they can always pray for blessings to be upon their children and upon the minds of their children's children and the generation that will come along behind us. We pray that none of our generational curses will come upon our children that are being born here. We want to thank you again, Father. Protect and guide their minds, Father. Direct their thoughts in ways that is pleasing to you, Father. Do not let them be given over to sinful desires of their nature, Father, for the dangerous wanderings of the mind. Help them to cast down their imaginations. And, Father, help them not to meditate on things that are unrighteous and unhealthy and sinful. Do not let them cause pain to others or themselves by allowing their minds to go undirected. We pray that you are the director of our minds. So we are asking you to direct the minds, hallelujah, of your children right now, Heavenly Father. Hallelujah. We praise and bless you. We want only the best for your children, for our children and our children's children. Father, keep them from thought processes that lead them to fear and have anxiety and depression and self-pity and pride and fornication and adultery, deception, or any kind of impurity. We pray, touch all of our minds right now, Father, right now. Touch the mind of our children as they continue to develop, no matter how old they are. Hallelujah. We ask that you remove childhood catches and kicks and iron them all out. Help them to think on holy things, things that are true and praiseworthy. Father, remind them to dwell on facts and to listen to your Holy Spirit and not be directed solely on how they feel. I'm asking you to anoint them in their inward parts so their feelings will not carry any of them astray. Guide them into all purity and sound thought processes, Father. That is what your word does. Touch our children's children and our children, hallelujah, to abide in the word, Father. Hallelujah, throughout the word. Father, I pray you will guard their hearts and their minds in Messiah Yahushua, Philippians 4:7. Let them be transformed by the daily renewing of their minds, training themselves to focus on what is your good and perfect will. I'm asking you to do that, Romans 12:2. As we all continue to grow up, grow older, We still pray that you would bless our children and keep their minds stayed on you and always trying to reach out and to love the neighbor as themselves. I pray you would open their minds like a gate and let your wisdom and understanding flow into all of their minds right now, Father, maturing and nurturing them to a greater love for you and increased knowledge of your Holy Spirit, Luke 24:44. In Yahushua's name, we ask you to do this, O Heavenly Father, for your great name's sake, 1 Peter 1:13. Prepare your minds for action. Be self-controlled. Set your hope fully on the grace to be given to you when Yahushua HaMashiach is revealed. Do not conform any longer to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what Yahuwah's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will, Romans 12:2. Father, I'm asking you to do this for all of us. That includes my mind as well. And the peace of Yahuwah, which transcends all understanding, will guard our hearts and our minds in Messiah Yahushua. Whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is praiseworthy, think about such things. Philippians 4:7-8. When our children's minds wonder, when our minds wonder, when anyone that hear this audio, if their mind wonders, we asking you to bring them back so that they can take a drink of the living waters. Hallelujah. Living waters of righteousness that they may drink long. We're asking you to protect them, Father. Your word said, but whoever drinks of the water that I will give him will never be thirsty again. The water that I will give him will become in him a spring of water welling up to eternal life, John 4:14. For Yahuwah so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life, John. Hallelujah. I just want to thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Yochanan 3:16. For we pray for our children. I want to thank you, Father. Hallelujah. It says those that drink of this water will never thirst again. So we stand on your promises for our children, Father, that they would be strong and courageous when trouble comes. I want to thank you, Father. Hallelujah, for filling up to them to overflowing. We want to thank you for protecting them when they are out of our eyesight. Protect them when they are in our eyesight. Hallelujah, because, Father, we lift up our eyes to the hills from whence comes our help. Our help comes from you, Father, who made heaven and earth. You will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. Yahuwah is your keeper. Yahuwah is your shade on your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. Yahuwah will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. Yahuwah will keep your going out and your coming in from this time forth and forevermore. Psalm 121. Keep our children. Our children are our future. I pray that our children, that some are graduating from 8th grade, going into 9th grade next year. Some are graduating from 12th grade. Some beginning their college, the first year in college. Some are graduating with their bachelor's degree. Some are graduating with their master's degree. Some are graduating with their PhD. Some are in kindergarten. Some are in daycare. Some are still in the womb. We pray, Father, for them. Don't let the enemy come along and use them, trafficking in sex and using them as sex objects. Oh, Father, touch our children that they will not walk away, but that they will listen to you and obey. I pray that you put the angels around our children. Hallelujah, Father, we depend on your word to fight for us and fix us up, family, father, mother, grandparents, All that are involved, Father. It said it takes a whole village to raise a child. It takes a family with love. Hallelujah. So I just want to thank you at this midnight time, Father, for our children. Hallelujah. Touch our children to know that they are wonderfully and fearfully made. Touch our children somehow, Father. Touch us so that we can share the word, hallelujah, by your Holy Spirit, what they need daily. Help us daily with our children and grandchildren and children's children and children's 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 children to the third and fourth, and some have lived to see four generations, some have lived to see five and so forth. I just want to thank you. I just wanted to pray for the minds of our children, all of them, regardless as to how old they are or how young they are. We pray over the minds of those that are developing right now. Hallelujah. I want to thank you right now, Father, for what you are continuing to do in our lives. Hallelujah. You promise that all things will work out for our good, and we stand on this promise. You said, for I know the plans I have for you, declares Yahuwah, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope in a future. That's what we pray for our children. We pray that our children love you. We pray that they are called according to your purpose. Our children and grandchildren, please help them rest on your promise that you work all things together for good, including sin, heartbreak, and tragedy, and trauma, and mental things, Father, that all will work together for their good. Help them to believe that you have great plans for them, plans that will prosper them and give them a hope and a future. We thank you that we can trust you, and then you put trust in us to trust those that have walked off of the path, Father, that we trust you in them as you guide our children. Help us not to put extra stress upon our children. Give us your counsel, Father, your wise counsel that you talk about in Isaiah 11. I'm asking that, Father, that you pour forth this anointing upon us in the situation that we find ourselves in. We forgive all of those that tried to harm us. We forgive and we pray for salvation of souls. Hallelujah. Isaiah 11, verses 1 and 2. A shoot will come up from the stump of Jesse. From his roots a branch will bear fruit. Boy, that is Messiah. And he said, abide in me. Hallelujah. If you abide in me, my word abide in you. You can ask anything. So I'm asking, Father, hallelujah, for your spirit. Says the spirit of you will rest on him, the spirit of wisdom and of understanding, the spirit of counsel and of power, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of Yahuwah, and he will delight in the fear of Yahuwah. I want to thank you, Father. I want to thank you, hallelujah, for giving us the tongue of the learning, giving our children the tongue of the learning and the ears of the learning so that they will know how to walk in this earthly realm. Hallelujah. Open up and anoint us. And while you anoint us, anoint our ears, hallelujah, that we may hear. Anoint our eyes that we may see. Anoint our minds that we may understand. And our hearts that we may know. Anoint us, Father, that we yield unto your Holy Spirit and open our mouth and cry out for help unto you. Please bless our children. I thank you for this midnight hour. I pray that this audio will touch others and that they would also bless their children as well and their children's children, Father, and stand on the promises as we give our children living waters to drink, and that is your word, and the bread of life is the Messiah, and I just want to thank you for putting it all together and for the plans you have for us. Hallelujah. May everyone that hear this audio go and read to Tehillim Psalm 139, and Father will speak to you about how he made you wonderfully and fearfully, and that he has plans for you. And his thoughts toward you are like grains of sand. Father, bless them going out, bless them coming in. Thank you, Father. Your whose light shine up on your countenance and grant you peace. And his name has been put up on you so that he will come and bless you. So you walk by faith and not by sight. Let your light shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Hallelujah.